This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use sensitivity analysis, some call it what-if analysis, to help managers make decisions. And the first point that I have here is that sensitivity analysis shows how the cost-volume-profit model will change with changes in any of its variables. For example, if we change total fixed costs, how will that impact profit? If we change variable costs up or down, how will that impact profit? Or perhaps the sales price might change, and again, how will that impact the bottom line? So sensitivity analysis provides us with a format to help us analyze that. In the second bullet point, I have some additional questions similar to what I just mentioned. How will profit change if the sales price goes up, let's say $30? Or how will profit change if fixed costs go up by 25% from our initial projection? Or perhaps how will profit change if sales volume decreases by 30%? That is, the number of units we produce and sell goes down. How will that impact the bottom line? So I'll give you a formal way to take a look at this on the next slide. The information in this slide goes back to a previous lecture that I have on YouTube related to Snowboard Company. So I'll just give you a quick refresher on this in the event that you haven't seen that other lecture. The base case here provides us with what we call our best estimate at what we think our sales price will be per unit, just going line by line here, what we think our sales price will be per unit, what we think our variable cost per unit will be, what we think our monthly total fixed cost will be, and the volume of sales. How many units do we expect to sell? Then the results of all that information are put into basically a contribution margin income statement, where we provide what our best estimate is related to the sale of, I think in this particular example, it was the sale of a snowboard, a particular model of snowboard. So to parse this out a bit, if you look at the base case, we think our sales price per unit will be $250 for this snowboard that we are going to be selling. And we expect to be able to sell 700 units. If you take 700 times 250, then we would get $175,000 in expected total revenue. We also have expected variable cost per unit of $150, and if we multiply that by 700 units, that gives us total variable costs of $105,000. And then the difference between the total revenue and total variable cost is our contribution margin in total. And subtract from that our expected fixed costs, and we think that our operating profit will be about $20,000. So that's our best estimate related to this snowboard that we are planning to sell in the future. The analysis that you see here shows what will happen if we change variables related to the base case. So if, for example, we increase the price by 10%, the second column of numbers that you see here, then the sales price will go from $250 to $275. And that $275 is simply the 10% increase, or you could take 10% times $250, $25, and add that to $250, and that gives us $275 as our sales price per unit. Everything else stayed the same. In this example, the $150 per unit for variable cost, $50,000 for total fixed costs, and 700 units, it was just the sales price. We wanted to know, for example, what would happen if the sales price was higher, 10% higher, than we had anticipated. Well, now that we have this information related to this new scenario, we plug it in, as we talked about before, to the contribution margin income statement, and here are the numbers. If we did increase our sales price by 10%, then our total revenue, of course, would go up, assuming the units sold are the same. Our total revenue would go up to $192,500, and that number is the $275 per unit times 700 units. Remember, we're selling the same number of units as before, so the variable costs in total stay the same at $105. Contribution margin will go up because our sales price went up. $192,500 minus $105,000 is $87,500. Our fixed costs stayed the same in this scenario, and our operating profit is expected to go up to $37,500. Now, the information you see at the bottom down here relates to this new scenario as it is compared to the base case. If you look at our operating profit of $37,500 and compare that to the original base case of $20,000, our profit would go up. If the price went up 10%, our profit would go up $17,500. And then the next item down here, the percentage, shows us the percent increase over the base case. So the 87.5% that you see here, this 87.5% is calculated by taking $17,500, that's our increase, and dividing that by the base case profit of $20,000. So that gives us 87.5%. So what that means is if we increase the price 10%, our profit would go up 87.5%, a huge increase in profit relative to the increase in sales price. Some would say that this means our profit is very sensitive to changes in sales price, and they would be right. If the price went down 10%, we would see the same result here, but in negative numbers. We would see the profit going down by $17,500 or going down by 87.5%. So this format that you see here provides us with a way of looking at what will happen to profit if we change certain variables. In this example right here, we change the price to increase 10%. We also have some other scenarios here showing what would happen if the sales volume goes down 10%, that is to 630 units from the original base case of 700 units. And then the third scenario shows us what will happen if two things change, if the fixed costs go down by 30%, so from the original case over here on the left of 50,000 to 35,000 now, that's the 30% decrease, and if the variable costs go up by 10%. So instead of 150, then we would see $165 there per unit for variable costs. So these are different. I'm not going to go through these in detail, the second and third scenario. You can take a look at these on your own. But this is the format that we use to show what will happen to the bottom line. Often it's operating profit we're evaluating. What will happen to the bottom line if we change certain variables within our initial base case that you see over here to the left?